Illinois bats. General information. Bats are mammals. They are the only mammals with true flight. Their wings are made of the skin of the arm, hand, and fingers. All bats of Illinois feed on insects. Because insects are not available year-round in our state, bats must hibernate, migrate, or adjust their activity in some manner to survive the winter. Mating occurs in late summer or fall, with fertilization delayed until late winter or spring. Female bats bear live young and feed them after birth with milk produced from mammary glands until the pups can fly on their own. Predators of bats include cats, raccoons, hawks, owls, shrikes, opossums, skunks, snakes, and weasels. 13 species of bats are currently recognized as living in Illinois. Echolocation. All bats that live in Illinois have a special hearing system for locating food and navigating in the dark. This process is called echolocation. In echolocation, bats send out high-pitched squeaks that bounce off objects and return to the bat as echoes. Humans usually cannot hear these sounds, although we hear some other sounds that bats make. Bats' large, sensitive ears help to collect the returning sound waves. The tragus is a pointed projection of the external ear. It helps channel sound waves into the ear. Echolocation allows bats to recognize the size, shape, and texture of an object and determine if it is moving. It is only used on objects that are a short distance away from the bat. With this system, bats may fly accurately in total darkness. Conservation. Bats are very important ecologically and economically. They are predators of night flying insects. They reduce insect pests of agricultural crops. Although none of the species that live in Illinois do so, many bat species are pollinators. Bat populations are declining worldwide. In Illinois, 4 of the 13 species present in the state are listed as endangered, and 2 are threatened. Cave closures, habitat loss and/or disturbance, accumulation of insecticides, intentional killing, wind turbines, and diseases, such as white nose syndrome, are all contributing factors to the reduction of bat populations. Human fears and misunderstandings also negatively impact bats. What can be done to help bat populations in Illinois? The Illinois Wildlife Code, the Illinois Endangered Species Protection Act, and the Federal Endangered Species Act are laws that help protect bats. The Illinois Cave Protection Act is designed to protect caves and the animals that live in them. Gates that allow bats to enter and exit, but keep people out, have been installed at the entrance of some caves. Forest habitat and large dead trees can be preserved. Bat houses can be built or purchased and installed. Education is a tool being used to overcome negative perceptions of bats. White nose syndrome. White nose syndrome is a disease that is devastating bat populations in North America. Caused by the fungus Pseudogymnoascus destructans, it has resulted in the death of millions of bats. This fungus grows in cold, moist conditions, and hibernating bats are very susceptible. It was first found in the United States in the winter of 2005 and 2006 in New York and spread quickly. White nose syndrome was first detected in Illinois in the winter of 2012-2013. The fungus is present in Europe, but does not cause such high mortality rates there. It is believed that it reached the United States by someone unintentionally transporting the fungus from Europe. Clothes, equipment, and shoes can transport the fungus. Bats can carry and pass along the fungus through physical contact with other bats. The fungus appears as a white coating on the nose and wings of infected bats. Infected bats change their behavior. They may fly outside in winter. They hibernate closer to a cave entrance than normal, where temperatures are colder and not as stable as deeper in the cave. Infected bats become active more often than normal, using up fat reserves needed for hibernation. Infected bats usually die of freezing or starvation. The Indiana bat, eastern small-footed bat, tricolored bat, little brown bat, northern long-eared bat, and big brown bat are the species most affected. All of them hibernate in caves. Currently, there is no method to treat infected bats or eliminate the fungus. Some caves have been closed to people, but bat-to-bat contact and physical transport cannot be stopped. Bats and rabies. All mammals are susceptible to rabies, and some mammals act as a reservoir for these viruses. The rabies virus attacks the central nervous system, resulting in swelling of the brain and sometimes the spinal cord. Rabies infections generally occur when saliva from the infected animal enters a wound on the victim's skin, such as from biting or scratching with claws. A rabies infection can be fatal to any mammal, including humans. The wild mammals in the United States most commonly affected by rabies are foxes, raccoons, skunks, and insect-eating bats. In Illinois, the majority of rabid animals found are insect-eating bats. Humans are more likely to be in contact with rabid bats than other rabid animals because bats tend to live in closer association with humans. Rabid bats are often slow-moving or sluggish and may be seen during the day in places that you would not expect to see a bat. The main method of avoiding bat-related rabies infection is to not pick up or touch bats. Your pets may contact a rabid animal without your knowledge. Dogs in Illinois must be vaccinated for rabies. Many local governments also require cats to receive rabies vaccinations. These efforts greatly reduce the spread of rabies to humans. If you see a bat that you think might be showing symptoms of rabies infection, call your local animal control department, police department, or natural resources biologist to report it. Do not pick up or touch the animal. The incidence of rabies in wild bat populations is very low. Rabies rates for bats tested for this disease tend to be higher because many more bats that are diseased or injured are tested than are healthy bats. In the United States, very few people are infected with rabies each year. A vaccine to combat the virus is effective if administered soon after exposure. If you should be bitten by an animal suspected of having rabies, seek medical assistance immediately. Species. More information about each species and bats in general can be found on the Illinois Bats poster from the IDNR. Order or view the poster on our publication's website. This poster was funded in part by the Decatur Audubon Society, Decatur, Illinois.